Hi, friends. 10 minutes the little way with me. 10 quality minutes because less is more. Focus and be totally and completely here, okay? You're going to need your hand weights and a tube. Bring those out and let's get going. Once we hit the music. All right, here's what you're going to do. 10 jumping jacks. 1, 2, 3. You can modify. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Grab your weights. You'll do 10 lunges. This whole thing is kind of a series of 6 exercises for 10. Actually, I meant to do jumping jacks for 10 seconds, but we'll do that on the other side. It's 5, 6, 7. Good. 8, 9, and 10. Well done. Put it down. Knees up for 10 seconds. Philippians 3:8-9. For his sake, this is Paul saying, for Christ's sake, I have suffered the loss of all things and count them rubbish. Good stuff. 10 push-ups. For Christ's sake, I've suffered all things. I've lost. Right? All things. 9. You can be on your knees. There's 10. Good job. Come up. Woo, grab your tube. You're going to choke it up a little bit. Oh, my tube is doubled up. That's fine. I'll double it up. Wide. Pull. Lat pull down. There's 3. Squeezing the shoulder blades together. I'm going to turn around. Squeeze the shoulder blades together. 5, 6. Exhale, 7. Bellies are strong. For his sake, I've suffered the loss of all things. That's a crazy statement right there. Stop. Right? 10-second shuffle. Side to side. We're knowing that Christ interrupts everything. He interrupts everything. He turns everything on its head. The way up is down. You want more? Be less. Go for less. The poor, rich, stop. Good. Grab your weight. Feet out wide. Come up and do a sword draw. 1, 2. Your heels are in, your toes are out. Don't move fast. 6. Move better. 7. I'm telling you, be totally here. 8. You're not just checking a box. 9. This is obedience. Just suffer a little bit so that gains can be made. Amen. 10 seconds. Count them all as rubbish. I'm telling you, friends, it's a weird gospel. And it kind of ruins you. Amen. It's one of those things where disciples start to turn back. And Jesus talks words that they go, this is hard teaching. It's hard for us to understand. But that's why it's called faith. It's not hard to do. It's actually quite easy. The work is easy. The way is difficult because it comes against our earthly reasoning. It comes against my checkbook. Comes against the words of hurt, as somebody else said. That's the hard stuff that happens in life. The struggle's real. God is true. And his truth will prevail. You can be just doing this, by the way. 3, 2, 1. Push-ups for 10 seconds. Doing great. I am convinced that you don't need more than this. If you continue to go about your day, follow the challenge. We've talked first week, we got right to food. We're going after substance over shadows, right? more substance from our food, less shadow eating, right? Foods that just represent real food, less shadows, more substance. So I'm convinced. I want to hear the testimony of the 30-day challenge. People that said, you know, I just did 10 minutes and it changed me. It may not reflect on the scale the way you want, but how about the weight of your heart, which is what is weighed? Scripture says that Christ, man looks at the outside, but Christ, he weighs the heart. All right, shuffle side to side. Side to side. Just 10 seconds. So you're 10 seconds of a best shuffle. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Well done. Grab the weight. Back to that plie. Sword. So whenever you get stuck in thinking you need to be more, do more, that it's not happening, basically when you lose your faith, and the faith is connected to peace and joy. That's how I know I'm living from a kingdom perspective if I have peace and I can be joyful. And the joy of the Lord is my strength, and the strength of the Lord is my joy. So whatever I feel I'm capable of, doesn't matter. That's a good sign, actually. It means, hey, guess what? I'm gonna need more. I'm gonna have to take a withdrawal on the kingdom. I'm gonna have to consider lost my dignity or my plans that I made according to the world. I'm gonna have to take a loss. So I ask you, have you taken a loss lately? You know? Have you taken a loss? Where you go, I don't know, okay God, just lunge back. If you want to add a bicep curl, you can do that. Hang on. Exhale, keep your heart up. Transfer the weight, hip to heel, hip to heel. Two more. Two. And one. Good job. Tell me, this is no joke. 10 minutes. Breathe. Again, you can just be here. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. I love that Paul can go on, say, I consider this all loss. It's all rubbish. For I've gained Christ. This little way is about losing your concept of what it's supposed to be, what your fitness of your body should look like, what fitness of your marriage should look like, the expectations that we place on the kingdom. Those expectations, you guys, trust me, they don't work out. I've tried to leverage myself against the Lord, and all I ended up with was a bitter heart and wasted time. I want my time back. But God, he'll repay twofold recompense. Good, just like Job. 6, 7, you're close. 8, 9, pull apart. 10, good. 10 second shuffle, go. Breathe. Wow. Ah! I've suffered the loss of all things and count them as rubbish in order that I may gain Christ. Stop. In order that I may gain Christ. Paul's figured out the one thing. And he's made his life about the one thing. He's been marvelously ruined. 3, 4. Keep your belt of truth on. Your abs. Engage. 7. 8. 9. Last one. 10. last 10 seconds, jumping jack. You want to take an arrow jack, a star jack. You can do that. Advanced people, you know how to turn it up. Stop. But don't fall into the pit that you have to. Listen, unless you're training for some type of fitness competition, this is sufficient. You're training for fitness of life, daily living, to be fit for today. I just so desperately would love us to be these peculiar people that we point to a different way. So when people go, "Oh, you look different. You look well. What are you doing?" And you can say, "I'm just following Christ. He's taking me down a narrow road." Stop. Amen. He's taking me down a road where I'm losing the things that I really needed to lose. I thought I needed to lose weight. It was never about the weight. It was about the things that have weighed my heart down. And it's my faith now that's training me. This is all Jesus' fault. That's what you can say. Go cool down. Try a cool down if you have time. Move to that. Otherwise, little way. Narrow. Listening to the voice. Any minute you're tempted, which surely there will be, because this is good seed and the enemy wants to come steal this. Hey, you might want to even try to justify and go, "Hey, that's worth a chocolate cookie," or whatever the heck that thing is. You've already made your agreements to try a little narrow way just for 30 days. Doesn't mean you'll never have a cookie again. I just say, if you know that's what you usually do, that's your go-to, you partner with that type of unbelief or temptation or accusation, there's a fear under there or a craving, really go to the other side. Eat more substance, less shadows. Seek the one who is substance, and the shadows will have to flee. See you next time.